Hey, Clearly Essential team, welcome to another interview with an amazing Rockstar team member. I'm really excited about this call. As many of you know, last month in October, Ronna Stewart promoted to Gold, and she also had, you may not have realized, a couple of people who promoted to Premier in a pretty short amount of time. And one of the things that's really impressed me about Ronna in her journey is since she started sharing the oils intentionally and really building a business about 14 months ago, she has consistently been one of our top enrollers, and maybe not always in the top three that you see recognized in the Facebook group and newsletters and things, but I see her name pretty consistently within the top 10. And she has been in the top three on a regular basis over the last 6 months as well. So last month, she also had 10 personal enrollments. And we'll talk a little bit more about that as well. But it's really exciting. As you know, we don't see someone promote to gold every day. It's a huge accomplishment. It takes a lot of teamwork and a lot of determination working together toward that common goal and having some committed sharers and builders in place who are willing to rally around that goal and work together to make it happen. So it's really, really exciting. And I know that Ronna was introduced to doTERRA by Diamond Alicia Latour, her friend, about 3.5 years ago, but she didn't start sharing right away. She was a product user, an oil user, and fell in love with the oils for a good while first before she decided to start sharing. So Ronna, welcome. Thank you so much for being with us. And I want to let you go ahead and tell us a little bit more about yourself, your background, your family, kind of what your daily life looks like.
Sure. So I'm 35 years old. I grew up and still live in Graham, North Carolina. I have three babies I stay at home with. Cora is 5, Cade is 3, and Violet is 18 months old. I worked before as a cake decorator at Food Lion, and then I worked as the bank teller, and then I spent about 7.5 years as a dental assistant, and been married to my husband for about 13.5 years, and my daily life is just basically, you know, home duties, cleaning and taking the kids to play school and just taking care of them. They're small, so they need quite, you know, a little bit more of hands-on still, but not a lot of extracurricular, you know, to keep up with. And we're heavily involved in our church as well. So between doTERRA and being a stay-at-home mom, that keeps me pretty busy and fills my day from start to end.
Yeah, it does. So 3 kids, 5 and under, and busy family life, husband who works full time, lots of church involvement, I know. So yeah, you're very busy, and I know people are going to want to hear a little bit more about how you balance all of that. But first, let's kind of go back to the beginning for you. And what was it that drew you to using doTERRA's products, and kind of what were some of those first successes you saw with the oils?
Well, when I first enrolled, that was, like I said, about probably 3.5 years ago, and it was at the beginning of Alicia's journey, too. And so she has learned so much, too, in 3.5 years as far as supporting her clients and things like that. So initially, I kind of used them here and there, but as she learned more, then, you know, we learned more. I remember what initially got me to enroll was she had one of the hand scanners on her laptop at her home, and my mom had just recently passed away unexpectedly. And so she scanned my hand, and I was kind of like, you know, let's see if this really works. What is this going to say? And so the oil that popped up was Citrus Bliss, and that kind of went along with what I was going through at the moment. So that was kind of got my attention a little bit and inspired me to go ahead and enroll. But as my kids, I started to have kids and they got older, and I started seeing more on Facebook and hearing more from Alicia about how I could help them with ear infections and things like that, I got more interested and began to use it more. And after my third baby, I struggled with yeast infections on my breast, and I was able to knock it out with Melaleuca, and that really inspired me to want to share with others, because that is extremely painful, and I was able to take care of it in about 24 hours. So that's what kind of got my wheels turning as far as doing it as a business.
Okay, awesome. Well, I love that, because it was about you really getting familiar and finding things that worked and having your own testimonial and story to share with others, and then just kind of couldn't help sharing because it helped you and you wanted to help others, which I think is a really common story that we hear with people who started building the business and didn't initially intend to do that. So for you that was very similar to what a lot of us experienced. But what was it like when you decided to start? Did you have an official launch week, or did you kind of start gradually sharing and then decide you wanted to build a business?
So initially I was helping Alicia sample, and I did that for about a week or two, and I realized quickly as I was posting on social media that I had a lot of people interested and willing to listen to me and talk to me about it. And she said, you know what, why don't you just try this and see how you do? And I've always had an entrepreneurial heart, and I wanted to have my own type of income. You know, I was always raised to be very independent, pull my own weight, that type of thing. And so I liked the idea of me being able to help support my family, or even just simply, when we first talked, you know, she asked me, what did I want? And I was like, I just want to be able to buy my husband a Christmas present with money that I earned. You know, it felt funny to go spend his money to buy him a Christmas present. And so when I told her that, she kind of laughed. She's like, oh, you're going to be able to do that. So we still laugh about that today.
That's really sweet. I love that. That's a really cute story.
Yes.
So did you have any familiarity with network marketing or any experience at all with sales?
Absolutely not. I've shied away from that my whole adult life. You know, you get invited to all the little parties and you buy the little knickknacks or the clothes or dishes. And I always totally tried to avoid those if I could. And I had no desire, even the first 3 years that I was, the first 3 years of that Alicia was involved with doTERRA, you know, we were close and we go to church together. Lots of the women in our church do this. I had absolutely no desire to do this. And it was just like, really, God called me to do it, to be honest. You know, she was a caveat to that, but he called me to do it. And I actually began doing it, and I didn't really want to. So I didn't start off with a launch because we hadn't quite learned that part yet. She hadn't brought that back to us from Prague yet. So when I started, I just went to a lot of her classes. I took a lot of notes, and I was extremely nervous when I first started. And it's just been interesting to see how far we've come, or how far I've come since that beginning.
Yeah, absolutely. We've all learned a lot. So what is different now that you teach your newer builders or your leaders that you didn't do? Maybe something you wished you had known, or maybe you would have done differently if you had known back then what you know now?
Well, let's see. I guess just to know how much I'm going to be stretched out of my comfort zone, and that the results that it's going to have is amazing. So that would have made me feel a little bit better about it initially, because I was so super nervous. I actually would not stand up to teach a class till I had been doing this about 6 months. So
wow.
Yeah, it took me a while to get comfortable and get there. So that's for me probably the biggest thing, is I knew I needed to push through it. And it was super hard, and I knew it would be good in the end, but just to know ahead of time that it really is going to pay off, that probably would have helped me a little bit more.
Yeah, and that's good, because you can instill that confidence and belief in others. You've seen it pay off, and you know it works, and they can really kind of borrow your belief and know that it worked for you, and they can, you know, build that rapport and trust. So along that line, what do you do when you are launching someone new or teaching someone new how to start building? What are the steps that you take with a new builder?
Sure. So first thing is, when they come to me and they tell me they're interested, we do a business consult where we use the build guide. It usually takes about 30 minutes or so, depending on their questions. We go over different parts of the build guide. And then at the end, I ask them to make me a 100 names list and to get it to me within 24 hours. And depending on how fast, you know, I receive the list back, kind of lets me know the commitment or how excited this person is. Like, maybe they're more of a sharer, or maybe they're really a true builder. You know, it kind of helps me that way. Once I get the list back, we go through and we look for certain characteristics of people on the list. And those are the folks that we're going to invite first to their classes. We do 4 launch classes in a 7-day span. and I walk them through how to sample. We have a whole little guide that's like a flow chart, how to sample properly, how to follow up properly. And we want to get them to that positive experience and then get them to the class, because the whole idea behind the sampling is they are going to have that positive experience and they're going to come to the class not wondering if they're going to buy anything, but what they're going to buy. And ideally, when you have your launch class, you're going to have a class full of people who have tried different basic oils. And as you're teaching the class, you say, okay, who in here has used Breathe? Who in here has used Melaleuca? And they're raising their hand and they're sharing their personal testimonial and experience. And then they actually begin to sell the product for you. And, you know, they're going to be more apt to listen to their fellow people in the audience versus me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the initial steps of the launch. I'm making it sound super simple. It's a lot of, you know, footwork, delivering samples, following up. It's an exhausting time. I always warn everyone the first 6 to 8 weeks is exhausting, but especially if you're new to oils, you're learning a lot. You're, like I said, doing the delivery. And some of those seeds that get planted, you know, they may not be ready to be harvested for a year later. That's happened to me recently. I've had two brand new advocates that I actually sampled a year ago, and they're doing amazing. So it's just a busy time, and it's a lot of learning going on, but it really is awesome, because if they properly sample and invite to their launch, then they can launch their business to elite usually or higher in the first month of their doTERRA business.
Yeah, that's awesome. And I love how I'm just hearing a lot of what Elise Shetaby teaches and what we learned in Prague and what she teaches online as well in some of her trainings, because it's something that you can duplicate. It's very duplicable. And now we have the Empowered Success, which a lot of that was based on training by Elise and some of the other top leaders in our company, some of the verbiage they use. And I love that that follows along so well, just using the build guide, doing the 100 names list, looking at the characteristics, which are listed in the build guide. They're slightly different, some of them from Elise's 7 characteristics, but very similar, and focusing on those people first. And like you said, it's going to be a really busy couple of months getting launched effectively. But something that Elise always says that I love and have borrowed is, we can do this the effective way or we can do it the ineffective way. We can do this quickly, kind of like ripping off a Band-Aid really fast and get it over with. Or you can draw it out. And if that's what works better for your life, that's okay. I'm going to support you. But we know mentally that's more of a sharer who's going to have a slower process, not someone who's going to build and launch right out of the gate and do a lot of work, because we want to match their time commitment with our time commitment. Be careful and have those boundaries, not to overextend ourselves beyond their commitment level. And that's really important. It sounds like you've done a great job of that. And I know you've had, of course, 3 premieres now, so being Gold, and a couple of them just promoted last month. So kind of tell me a little bit about their process and what you've helped them to do, because I know one of them hit premiere in, what, 11 days?
Yes.
That's crazy.
Yes, I know. They both are very hard workers and were willing to do whatever I asked them to do. When I would call, it was not no or I can't. It was I'll try or I will. And that's all, you know, I could ask of them. They really did work really super hard at doing their social media, getting some really awesome enrollments during their launch week. And they're just amazing women, and they are influencers, so they do have people that listen to them, and that is one of the characteristics we look for.
Yeah, that's awesome. So they had a whirlwind launch, but obviously well worth it to be able to promote to premiere quickly. And I know that you had your own personal enrollments that helped as well. And here at 14 months in, what is that like for you? Do you feel like you've gone through your warm market, or where are you finding? You said you kind of, you in a message to me, that you kind of scraped together 10 enrollments. And I know people are going to wonder, how do you just scrape together 10 enrollments 14 months into this business?
So I had 2 hosted classes in October. One was a spa class, and I think I had maybe 3 or 4. I think I had 3 enrollments that night, and then one came through on October 30th from that class. And then the other hosted class, I had potential of 10 enrollments at the class, and I think I had probably 15 or 16 people there. And I ended up getting a builder from that class kind of out of the blue.
Awesome.
So she was somewhat interested, so we scheduled a business consult, we met, and then she actually took the majority of those enrollments from that class. So she got those. I did have two from that class. And then we were doing a study. So Alicia does studies with us through her Diamond Oils Training Center. And I had, I think, 13 applicants in our study this time. And I had some folks that were having such amazing results already. They were already wanting to order and enroll before the end of the study. So I'm literally sitting in the car rider line at play school to pick up my kids, and this lady calls, and she's had this amazing results with Citrus Bliss and Balance and then Elevation for her stress, and she enrolled with the Natural Solutions Kit on October 31st.
So, awesome.
You know, and then that morning, it's like God did all of this. I did all I could do. I did my part, and the last 2 days, I was like, okay, God, I've done all I can do. You've got to help me make up the rest. And that morning, I had a friend, she works at the hospital, and she was talking to a friend about oils, and they called me on speakerphone. I've never met the lady, and she's like, I just want to order this kit. Here's my information, and can you put it in for me? So it was just random. That's why I say scrape together, is because the two at the end of the month, you know, were kind of unexpected. And then I had at the very beginning of the month an older couple come to a class, and they enrolled with the Natural Solutions as well. So it was just kind of, and then, you know, we had the awesome Dream Collection available with the diffuser and the three free oils, and that really, it was just like everything lined up perfectly for me for October.
That's awesome. And I love this time of year because I feel like the specials and the volume and the things that are coming down the pipeline from doTERRA really help set us up. And October, November, and December are always amazing, amazing months. So anybody listening during this time period, this is such a great time to capitalize on those specials that are being offered, the new products, the holiday products, the 200 PV, the BOGOs, the frankincense, all these great things. And it's great too, because you can know that you'll have repeat volume if you do a great job following up and with your continuing education. To get people on LRPs, and then they see that frankincense special in December. So it's a really awesome time of year. I love seeing all the rank advancements and just all of the things that come to fruition. Like you said, it might have been someone you talked to a year ago or who did a study with you several months ago. But those are the things, those planting seeds, sampling, studies, continuing to do classes. And it sounds like you're continuing to find new people to host to introduce you to their friends and family so you can get outside of that warm market. So probably at this point, would you say most of the people who are hosting and enrolling are not people that were in your warm market 14 months ago when you started?
Yes.
Yeah. So what are some of the things you've done? Has it just been, like you said, sampling classes, anything other that's specific that helped you to kind of get outside of that warm market? Or was it just continuing to repeat classes and finding new hosts?
Yes, just doing the basics, of course. But what has really helped me, I believe, especially, is social media. Like I told you, my church was tapped out. I go to church with Alicia. She'd been in doTERRA for almost 3 years before I decided to do this. And so I also did not have a job. I was staying home with my kids. And so social media was pretty much my only outlet, I felt like. Just like Kelsey said earlier, when you're sitting there nursing your baby, you know, I started this when my third baby was seven and like maybe 8 weeks old or maybe 12 weeks old. And so you're sitting there, you know, and you're on your phone. So I just started to do that. And I got a lot of response that way. And I've continued to do that for lots of reasons. Number one is some people do ask me for samples, and then also it lets people know that I'm serious about what I'm doing, that I take this as a real job, as a business, and not just as a hobby. And I also had created very early on my own private oil page, And I load every person in I ever enroll in that page, and anyone who would ever be interested in just this not enrolled that just wants to learn in that page. And I do daily posts on ways to use. Sometimes I borrow some of my uplines things and I post in there. I do live videos in there. I do giveaways periodically throughout the month as well, just to keep, you know, the notification, like keep doTERRA and my clients, you know, field of vision. Mm-hmm. And that, I believe, has been a key component to my success. Just supporting my clients that way, the ones that are on Facebook.
Yeah, that's awesome. So it sounds like you do a lot of your continuing education that way through your group, your private group on Facebook. And I know you also have classes regularly. So about how many classes are you doing maybe per week or per month at this point? How many live events do you still do?
So I try to schedule myself 4 classes a month. And the last probably 2 or 3 months, I've had launches to do, like two people to launch each month. And so if I cannot combine them somehow, then I don't schedule myself any personal classes because that would be, you know, way too much. But I just invite my folks to the launch classes that I have. So I would say if I was to not have anyone to launch in a month, I would schedule 4 classes for myself to invite people to. And then, like you mentioned, we do have CE that Alicia provides. We all take turns, the advocates take turns teaching it. We all help run it. And we all invite our personal clients to that too. So that helps as far as continuing education does. We do sometimes team events where we might do a make and take or things like that. I've done over the summer, I did 2 health days is what I called it. And we advertised and did live videos and flyers on free blood pressure checks because I was, you know, trained for that for my schooling. And we would do a giveaway of a membership that people could enter, different ideas like that, prizes, things like that, that we will do.
That's awesome. It sounds like you stay very active and creative. You're not always just doing the same things, but coming up with new things to add in to continue to draw people in, whether it's on social media or through live events. There's a good balance there of just kind of depending on how you can best reach people through whichever avenue is going to reach them the most easily. So that's wonderful to hear. And that's what most of us have done. Most of us haven't built through social media, like we talked with Kelsey earlier, but most of us build through live events and then supplement or continue to educate through social media. But I know you've done a lot of Facebook live videos because I've seen a lot of those come through my notifications as well. So that's an effective way that you've been able to educate people, but also just kind of introduce the concept of doTERRA and how you're using it in your daily life through your friends, right? And that hasn't been something that's turned people off. It's been something that's drawn people in. Do you think there's a reason specifically why? Because I know sometimes people get turned off by that type of thing, but do you think it's your approach that has helped you with that?
You know, I'm not really sure what people think, but I can tell you that I do try to keep a balance of, I've always heard the 80-20 rule, you know, 80% personal and 20% business. And sometimes I get really excited about different promotions we have, and it probably might be a little bit flip-flopped, especially the beginning of the month. But I think that as far as my friends go on social media, they're happy to support me. As far as that goes, I don't think they get frustrated with it. But I can't really answer as far as what they really think. But I think that I just try to keep a balance so that they don't disregard my name when they see it come across. I try to do a lot of funny things like gifts and commenting. And sometimes it's interesting to me what people will comment on. And, you know, the more comments you get, the more clicks, the more likes, the better for you on Facebook. And that's why I do it, is I try to use humor or uplifting quotes and things like that to get people to say, oh, let me see what Ronna's got on there today. And they'll click on it. And the majority of the time, maybe it will make them laugh. Maybe it will make them smile. But then, you know, every so often they're seeing doTERRA as well. So that's kind of how I use social media.
Yeah, it's very similar to what we heard earlier, just being real and genuine and that balance of personal with business and just keeping it very real for people. So that's awesome. It sounds like you motivate people to come to classes mainly through samples and studies. Is that the main ways that you get people into classes?
Yes. Personal messages another thing that I did recently, we had a Premier and Above Builder Day that Alicia, Angela, and Lacey did. And one of the things that was suggested during that day was to rewrite your 100 names list. And I thought about it for a couple weeks and I thought, you know what, I'm going to do that. And so I went back and I rewrote my 100 names list. And it really shocked me at how brave I was at that point to write down names that before I would never have written down. Hmm. And so that gave me more people to message or call to invite to classes. And so I try to contact at least one person a day, if not more, depending on if the kids are, you know, allowing me time to think and go through things. But yes, just inviting, and I encourage everyone to redo that list periodically and get more, because also, you know, you're adding friends to your social media too, that you are new, and that way you can reach out to those people too.
Awesome. That's a great rule of thumb, just contacting one new person a day whenever possible, and also doing some kind of follow-up or reaching out to one person a day who's already on your team or who needs to be followed up with after sampling or a study. So that's a great rule of thumb to just continue to follow. And I love that even at the leadership levels, you're continuing to hold yourself accountable to doing those same basic activities, because that's what grows you to diamond, honestly. So I just see that coming for you. And I know that you've learned a lot about structuring too. And I think that's something that confuses people, that they can overcomplicate. So I wanted to see, just as someone who's farther along and has some structure, obviously that's required for gold, what are some tips that you tell people as far as placements and structuring successfully, how to do that well?
So I still will call Alicia sometimes, because I get nervous about, I'm a perfectionist at heart and I want to make the right decision and I don't like to make mistakes. So I do still call her and run things by. She's always great and tells me what her two cents is. But for someone who's a new builder, my advice would be to focus on one to two legs at a time and get those two legs to executive solidly, so that you can be solid premier before you go trying to overwhelm your mind with thinking of silver. So I would focus on two legs, making sure they're good to go, making sure you've got your membership overviews done for all of those people and that they're solid there. And then I would try to find that third advocate to start building with to get yourself to silver.
That's great advice. I love that. And so for you, how often do you find yourself communicating with your premier leaders and the other strong builders or leaders that you've brought into your business?
I probably have been communicating with, especially my premiers, just about every day, which has really been awesome. They're calling me, they're texting me, they're contacting me themselves. And that's been a really, really awesome to be able to work with them like that. As far as I try to do a monthly call right now with my team. And then I like to schedule individual strategy sessions with the advocates who want it. I'm willing to do it for anyone, no matter what their rank is. If they're an advocate in my downline, I would love to do weekly strategy sessions with all of them. And then for myself, I will have a weekly call with Alicia as well. And we just talk about what my goals are, you know, what my go over strategy, just checking in on different things like that. She's always really great to give me some fresh new ideas to think on and work on for the month.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. And if people are kind of mentally calculating this up and thinking, okay, sampling and studies and classes and social media, and then, you know, your leader communication and strategy sessions, it can sound like quite a few hours, but I know you spend a lot of time with your church service, with your family, with your husband. So how do you kind of balance all of that and juggle those different aspects of your life and keep your priorities, you know, keeping the first things first in your life?
So this has kind of gone quickly for me. And I was thinking about this earlier. I haven't really sat down and mapped out a plan and set up boundaries yet. But after last month, I thought it crossed my mind, you know, I really need to do that to protect, you know, that time with my family, because they are why I'm doing this. Of course, when you're pushing for a rank, you know, you do spend a whole lot more time than you normally do. So that's why October was even more busy for me. But, you know, since our kids are young, we don't have, you know, sports things or dance or, you know, things like that to run to throughout the week. So basically, you know, the evening time is when I have my classes and I schedule them for 6:30 or 7, and my husband's home by that time. What I do try to do is when I have a class in the evening and I have membership overviews I need to do, I'll try to do them before the class. And so that would mean I would need to have a babysitter that would come in usually around 3 o'clock, and they're here for about 3 hours while the kids are napping, or they might play with the ones that don't take a nap, you know. But basically I use like a babysitter periodically, and then my husband's here. So it's not too overwhelming, unless you're pushing for a rank, of course.
Right. We'll have those seasons, obviously, when things will seem out of balance and chaotic, and that's perfectly normal. And I think we have to accept that during those months that you're really pushing for a goal or helping a team member strive for a goal, you're not going to really have the same daily life and activities that you might in other months, but it's totally worth it, of course. And so it sounds like you're now reevaluating, you hit that rank, and of course you want to maintain it, but you've got those things in place for continuing education to do that, so you can kind of scale back a little bit as far as not being in that massive amount of activity pushing for every last enrollment, right? Yeah. So if someone were at the place you were maybe a couple months ago, a few months ago, looking at, you know, sitting at silver, maybe maintaining it, maybe not quite maintaining it, and really wanting to push for gold, are there some specific things you would advise them to do or any encouragement you could offer to them?
So first of all, just to believe in yourself and that you can do it. And, you know, I was at silver after 5 months, and then it took me to 14 months to do this. And I believe probably half of the time I was silver and half of the time I was not. And I remember Alicia had a business meeting, and she played a video from a blue diamond who's studying under Elise or mentoring under Elise. And what she said really resonated with me. You know, if you want gold, don't worry about anybody else. You just worry about yourself, and you go out and you do it and you get it yourself. And so I left from that meeting. I was just like, you know what? That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go out and I'm going to keep doing all the things, you know, the pipes, and doing all the things that I see the people who are being successful doing. And I'm just going to keep pushing myself. And so that's like the biggest thing that has helped me, is to not focus on others around me and worrying about what this person's doing and what this person's doing, but just to focus on myself and worry about myself. And when you have a month come along like October was, and you can look and see that it's possible, then yes, I would really amp up, like, trying to get hosted classes, reaching out to clients, asking them to host a class, looking through your entire tree, just combing through it and looking for folks that have volume that you might could really use somewhere else, and moving that around. And you know, throw in the BOGOs. Like, if you're in the last 48 hours or more and you want to try to go on and try, you could throw in a few BOGOs if you need to. But that would be my best advice as far as for gold. I had written down some notes, but I think I got most of it. You know, get your entire team motivated. That's another thing that I have. Get them involved and motivated. So, you know, I contacted some of my advocates, and we came up with some plans, and they were really excited to work and push as well. So yeah, that's it. Just focus on your what you're doing and make sure that you're leading by example and just go get it yourself.
That's awesome. I love that because it is focusing on what you're doing and looking in the mirror and saying, it's up to me. And yes, you need sharers and builders and team members who are working with you, but ultimately you can't point fingers at them and blame them. You have to know it's really up to me and then rally them and work with them personally. So did you work with them to come up with individual plans? Did you offer them maybe incentives and things that would motivate them to push for their goals too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Awesome. Well, that's amazing. I don't know if anyone has any questions. My last question is really just what you see going forward, what you see this doing for your family, kind of where you've been so far, what your doTERRA journey and the extra income for your family has meant, but also where you see yourself going forward, how this is going to impact your life and your family's life because you've decided to embark on this doTERRA journey and really commit to building as a leader.
So my goals are, for number one, I want to send my kids to Christian school where I went. That is very important to me that they are going to be able to go there. And when I achieve silver, I then had enough just to for all three to go. It's quite expensive. And, you know, that was like my main thing. And so then it's like, as I've gone each little step, my dreams or goals or what I think could happen has grown too. Next would be, you know, my husband. He works really hard for us. He never complains. He gets up at 4:30 and he doesn't get home till 6 or 6:30. He didn't get home tonight till 8 o'clock. So I would love to be able to provide, time freedom for him to be with us, to possibly have, you know, he loves to hunt and I love to fish. And so to possibly have a good piece of land where we could do those things with our children, be outside together, that type of thing. Over and above that, I would just love to have that time freedom to work together on projects for our church or missions or, you know, just to be available if someone needs their yard mowed or anything simple, you know, like that would be really neat, I think, to be able to do with the extra time we would achieve. My journey has just been amazing at how God has used doTERRA to stretch me and grow me so fast. Just like I already shared that I wouldn't even stand up to teach a class for 6 months. And now I don't even get nervous. I was nervous for this call, but as far as teaching a class, I feel like I'm very much in my element now and I'm not nervous anymore. But it's been amazing how he's used it. I have all kinds of like background where, you know, I was bullied and picked on and things like that. And that still affects me in my adult life. And I've had to work through all of those fears. And I think it's really cool how I never expected doTERRA to be the tool God would use to do that, to make me believe in myself and believe that I'm good enough.
Wow. That is beautiful. And you are amazing. I think most people who would look at you now and watching this interview would think, I cannot believe she struggled with confidence and was bullied and all of those things from your past. And I totally agree. This is what God will use to grow and stretch you and help you to overcome some of those fears and the things that have held you back in your life. And that is just one of the most beautiful parts of what we get to help others do, because when we've experienced that transformation ourselves, we can't wait to help others embark on that personal development journey and really become who they were meant to be and live up to that God-given potential. And it's just so beautiful to see that happen. And I know Alicia has taken such joy in helping you and getting to personally mentor you through that. So it's really neat to see what it's done for your life already and just moving forward, what you see it doing for you. And I can attest to what you said, just the time freedom for myself and my husband, since we hit diamond, being able to go on mission trips together, healing hands and co-impact trips, being able to be available to people in our community to help really at a moment's notice. That kind of time freedom was even more than what I think we ever imagined or dreamed. And it's just amazing to see that come to pass. And beyond anything we could have asked or imagined or thought, you know, God has done. So I see that for your future too. And I'm so excited to get to celebrate each of those steps with you. I personally just really appreciate your time. And I think this is going to help so many people just to hear the nitty-gritty truth of what it takes to get to gold and to be a leader and to rise up to that place where you're at, but that it's not complicated. It's really simple. It's really a matter of consistency and staying committed to the process and doing those basic things over and over and helping others to do that as well. And really just trying to be the best advocate on your team and lead by example is a huge take-home message that I think we can always stand to be reminded of. So thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. I don't see any questions coming through, but if anyone has them, please feel free to ask on our Facebook group where I post the recording, or even on the YouTube channel if you're watching the recording there. We'll be happy to help you in your journey however we can. And again, just thank you for your time and congratulations on so much success. I wish you so much more, and I know that you're going to have it because you're doing all the right things and teaching others that as well.
Thank you, and thank you so much, all of you guys, Alicia and you and Angela and Lacey, on up. The way you guys support us is just amazing, and it makes it so much easier for us, and I just want to thank you for all the time that you guys invest in us, and especially Alicia for all she has done for her entire team, too. So I just wanted to say that before we get off.
Oh, that's awesome. I know you have such an amazing community and such an awesome leader in Alicia, and I know she's going to be presidential diamond. We're all going to be celebrating that together, but I know it's my pleasure, and I'm sure for your other leaders as well, to support you and to encourage you and cheer you on. Sometimes we just feel like we're just cheerleaders, and is that enough? But sometimes just that encouraging word that I've been there, I know it's tough sometimes, but you can do it, I did it, and you can too, is really what people need to hear to just keep pushing forward. So I'm glad that it has helped you. And I hope that's true for everyone listening. So we love to support our team members. And I love that you even said you would happily do a strategy session with anyone in your downline. That is really the hallmark of a true sacrificial leader. And I see great things. I know Diamond is not far for you, my friend. So congratulations and thank you again.